So research in my lab over many years has been focused on identifying genes that are responsible for producing flowers in plants. In particular, we work on tomato, and flower production in tomato, like many crops, is critical for making fruits and seeds, which is of course very important for agriculture. So in our most recent research, we've identified a new gene that was critical for tomato to be cultivated in northern latitudes, such as the Mediterranean basin where it was first introduced over 500 years ago, as well as the northern latitudes of California and even further north into Canada. Now it turns out that this gene is actually responsible for preventing flowering when the days are very long. In order for tomato to now be grown in northern latitudes, we had to have a change in the function or the activity of this gene so that it wasn't active as much as in the wild. In particular, what we found is that when the activity of this gene was suppressed, tomato could now be cultivated in northern latitudes where the day lengths are longer, but the growing season is shorter. We then went a step further and asked, well, if we could completely eliminate the activity of this gene, mutate the gene entirely so that it no longer functions at all, then perhaps we could get even earlier flowering tomato varieties. And we in fact did this using a new and very powerful gene editing technology known as CRISPR. And by using this technology, we could pinpoint mutations directly in the gene. And when we generated these mutations, we then created plants that flowered 2 to 3 weeks earlier than most varieties. And this may sound like a very subtle change, but when you're talking to farmers, you understand that having the ability to generate fruits at an earlier point in the growing season is not only important for production in order to get to market faster, but also now opens the door to expanding the geographical range of where the tomato crop can be grown. For example, in even higher northern latitudes of Canada, where tomato seasons are very short. And so our hope is that from the discovery of this gene in the lab, that we can now implement this in other varieties of tomato and even other crops in order to achieve the same outcome of early yielding crops.